morning, everyone.
Morning.
I'm Monsignor Emmet Nevin. I'm the pastor of St. Aedan's. I'll be our celebrant today. We begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
The waters of baptism, James died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he share with him now eternal glory.
Shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. Face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you.
As I invite Tim to step forward and share some words of remembrance about James and his life.
Good morning. Thank you, Monsignor. Thank you all for coming. Your prayers and support have meant everything to us. Jim was a strong man in his convictions, in his purpose, and in his faith. He would never quit or take no for an answer. He was a man who often defied the odds and sometimes baffled modern medicine, trusting his faith and support from his family and friends. Hope was always present. He was hoping, as we all were, to get a few more months so he could share in his daughter's special day. And although that plan has been altered, please be assured, Pop will be with us on that day and days to follow. From the moment Dad first stepped on U.S. soil in February 1958, some 63 years ago, he has been guided by his faith and work ethic to become the man we all love and respect. His journey touched many people and created lifelong friends. Many of those people are here today to join us in celebrating Dad's life. He didn't dilly-dally very long in the U.S. When Cupid strikes, it's impossible to resist. He probably figured it was too good to be true. A beautiful girl from County Sligo, Theresa Beglin. So he did what any wise man would do. They got married in October 66 in Good Shepherd Parish in Inwood, New York. Together they formed a bond in marriage and love that would bless them with three children and four grandchildren that they absolutely adore. Pop always started every conversation with, "How's the kids? Are the kids okay?" "Pop, the kids are fine, and Mama will be also, we promise." Mom and Dad's 54 years of marriage has taught us some simple principles to live by. faith, family, respect, and compassion. Dad always believed in the importance of work. In his eyes, there was no excuse not to work. Believe me, I tried coming up with a few good excuses. I mean, like really good ones, but he wasn't having it. Just to give you an idea, this man in 1977 walked during the blizzard from Pelham Bay all the way to the other side of the Bronx to Riverdale because, his words, I have to open this door. He wholeheartedly believed your name was everything. It was all you truly own. It identifies your character, your merit, and your morality. Well, James O'Donnell, you have set the bar high, extremely high. We can only hope and strive to achieve the same. Family and dear friends were very important to Dad. He made many lifelong friends on this side of the ocean, giving us all very happy memories and stories to share. The family tree extends well into Ireland, and Dad's 4 brothers and 5 sisters, in-laws, cousins, nieces, and nephews. And it's a testament to him how, before technology and being 3,000 miles away, he was able to keep his roots strong and healthy. He believed in togetherness, support, laughter, and love. He believed family and friends was a gift that should be embraced and nurtured. Dad never forgot where he came from or who he was. He was proud to be an Irishman from Devon Road, Templeglantine, County Limerick. His love for Irish football and hurling drew him into Gaelic Park. It was here he dedicated many years of service with the Kerry Football Club and the GAA. His passion for Kerry football drove him from player to becoming chairman of the club and later president of the club. The Kerry Football Club has bestowed upon Dad the honor of being named the lifelong president of the Kerry Football Club. There's even a rumor out there that Dad was a member of the 1973 Kerry Juniors Hurling Championship here in New York. Search for a video, it's underway, I don't know. If we get it, we'll share it. Dad was also an avid fan of the New York Giants and the Yankees. His history of baseball and football was pretty spectacular, with his spiffballing about Murderer's Row or the Polo Grounds. Those are great chats. He loved all kinds of history. You know, it didn't matter if you were building something, preparing a party, or just picking someone up from the airport. Dad's opinion was voiced and heard. He usually started it with, "I was thinking." More often than not, you would let out a sigh or just try and run. You knew what was coming. The man was always thinking. Well, the past few days and weeks, we have been thinking. How great a husband and father you were. How the simple things made you happy. How great a friend you are. How great a grandfather you were. How hard you worked, and how important family is. We have been thinking of you, Dad, and how much we loved you, and we will miss you. Thank you for everything.
Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant James, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. The family chose as its first reading a book from the book of Ecclesiastes. There is an appointed time for everything and a time for every affair under the heavens, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to uproot the plant, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to scatter stones and a time to gather them, a time to embrace and a time to be far from embraces, a time to seek and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to rend and a time to sow, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to love and a time to hate, a time of war and a time of peace. What advantage has the worker from his toil? I have considered the task which God has appointed for men to be busied about. He has made everything appropriate to its time and has put the timeless into their hearts without men's ever discovering from beginning to end the work which God has done. I recognize that there is nothing better than to be glad and to do well during life. The word of the Lord.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. You'll spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The second reading is from the letter of Paul to the Romans. Those who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption through which we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God and joint heirs with Jesus. If only we suffer with him so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains even now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who are the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Jesus Christ. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might have eternal life. Glory and praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, Amen, I say to you, whoever hears my word and believes in the one who sent me has eternal life and will not come to condemnation, but is passed from death to life. Amen, I say to you, the hour is coming and is now here when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so also he gave to his Son the possession of life in himself. And he gave him power to exercise judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not be amazed at this, because the hour is coming in which all who are in the depths of the earth will hear his voice and come out. Those who have done good deeds to the resurrection of life, but those who have done wicked deeds to the resurrection of condemnation. The Gospel of the Lord. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Ecclesiastes speaks to us, I think, about things we can identify with as a time for just about everything we can think of in the heavens. There was a time when my family came from Ireland, the Nevins from Galway City, the McLaughlins from a little place called Ballisfader in Sligo. And the time came to come here to this country and to start over a brand new life. And it wasn't easy. Particularly back in the day when Irish were not welcome and Catholics particularly were not welcome. So it was hard to make a living. But the faith of these people is the faith, I think, of which we're talking about today with James. To have faith is the foundation of your life. You can take on struggles. You can make sacrifices. You can even take risks on behalf of other people because you know that God is with you, that God is your constant companion in life, no matter where life takes you. So at the beginning of James' life, when he entered this world, a candle such as this was lighted. It reminds us that Jesus Christ is the light of the world. He is the light who overcame the darkness of death and the darkness of sin and allows us to follow more clearly the path that leads to God our Father. A garment, a white garment, is placed on him just like every other baby, reminding us of the outward sign of our Christian dignity. And we're admonished to bring that Christian dignity unstained into the everlasting kingdom of heaven. Holy water is placed upon us, remembering the baptism of Jesus in the water, and also reminding us that we who die with Christ will one day rise with him into eternal life. This holy sacrifice of the Mass that is so familiar to us is the most perfect prayer of the Catholic Church. There is nothing more beautiful, more profound, that captures us up into the mystery of God's love and his plan of salvation than being here at this Mass. To not only be together in this holy place, to hear the word of God in sacred scripture, to be at this table where God invites us to his table to enjoy not just a symbolic meal, but really the body and blood of Christ itself. This is something that James would have been very familiar with in his life, and so he is presented here before this altar now. Ecclesiastes tells us there's a journey of life. You know, as we go through life, things are not always the same. Sometimes day to day, we may get into a routine. Things may seem not to be too different. But ultimately, as we look over week by week, year by year, we know that things do progress. We get older. Hopefully, we get wiser. We experience some wonderful things that God allows us to enjoy in this life, and we also, of course, experience some of the bad that comes with being a human being living in this world. We try to get through the ups and the downs and the ins and the outs, the sacrifices, the demands, and sometimes the hardships, knowing that we're not alone. For those who are fortunate, we have a family. We have a loving wife or a loving husband. Then we have children and grandchildren, nieces and nephews, brothers and sisters, people who are close to us by blood. Even more grateful are we for those who are friends that we meet at work or meet in the community, meet in the church, but people that are there because they enrich our lives. They make life so much worth living. And of course, if we can, we give back to them what we have received, because that's the give and the get and the getting of life. But today, what we're talking about here is a man of faith who knew that as each step of life unfolded, it was really part of an ongoing journey, like little milestones along a road. And ultimately, as we travel the road, we're hoping to get to a destination. We don't wander aimlessly around road after road with no purpose in life. To James, the ultimate destination was, of course, eternal life in the kingdom of God. We pray to God for many things, and God, of course, in his own good way, answers our prayers. And sometimes the prayer is answered by saying, no, I have something else in mind for you. But nonetheless, we continue to pray that God will guide us and help us be strong as we make the journey of life. Ultimately, as our readings today have really revealed to us, the life that we live is really but a foreshadowing. It's a foretaste of the life that God intends for each and every one of us. Just as he would never tolerate his son to die forever, but raised him back from the dead, he will not tolerate we who are born again in baptism, who are his sons and daughters, for us to die forever either. We believe in the resurrection of the body and life everlasting. This is what we profess each and every day of our lives. This is what we profess at this very altar. This is what we celebrate here today. James has reached the end of this life's journey. He has passed the final milestone along that journey. He believed that at the end of this life's journey, God would take care of him because he believed in God as a loving father. And he believed that this life, as good as it can be, and as close as we can be to our family and friends, is not the final chapter in our book. So today we ask God, who blessed James with many good things in this life, many good blessings, so many things that we now cherish in our hearts, we now give to him that most precious gift of all, which is the gift of eternal life. The readings today talked about the final judgment. Those who live in the light, those who carry that Christian dignity in their hearts, those who believe in Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, those who remember the most important command God gave us, to love God and to love neighbor, and put it into action in our lives, those are the ones who can stand tall at the judgment. Those are the ones who can look God in the eye. Those are the ones whose hearts are really an open book for God to see how they thought and how they spoke and how they lived. And at that time, we're praying, as Ecclesiastes remind us, that as we do that last thing on earth and step forth into eternity, we have that loving God who's been watching us, taking care of us, and is there to welcome us. So today we thank God for the gift of James and his life, for the way he shared his life with all of you. And we pray that God will now take care of him for all eternity, where he will be waiting to one day greet each and every one of you as we begin that final journey of life that leads to eternity. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, amen. I invite those forward who will now help us with the prayers of petition. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we now join our prayers to his.
The response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Jim, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we praise the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brother Jim, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised on the last day, we praise to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, that for all who helped us, that they may have the reward for their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope to rise again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother Jim, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, hear the prayers of the Redeemer Jesus Christ and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by the blood of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place in the kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on. Lord, lead me home. When my way grows drear, precious Lord, linger near. When my life is almost gone, hear my cry.
Brothers and sisters, let us now stand and pray that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. As we humbly present to you the sacrificial offerings of the Lord for the salvation of your servant James, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, Aedan, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. With this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, the order of bishops, and all the people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. Your compassionate, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant James, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up the flesh of those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
We now pray for the coming of the kingdom as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
We turn and offer a gesture of peace to one another.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Eternal shine, O Lord, upon them. For endless ages with thy blessed ones, for thou art gracious. There were people of all ages gathered round the gabled wall, poor and humble men and women, little children that you called. and our hearts are just the same, filled with a joy at such a vision as we praise your name. Golden rose, queen of Ireland, all my cares and troubles as we kneel with our love before you, Lady of Knock, my Queen of Peace. Oh, your message was unspoken, but the truth in silence lies. So I gaze upon your vision, and the truth I try to find. Here I stand with John the teacher, and with Joseph at your side, and I see the Lamb of God on the altar glorified. Golden rose, queen of Ireland, all my cares and troubles as we kneel with our love before you, Lady of Knock, my Queen of Peace. And the Lamb will conquer, and the woman clothed in the sun will shine her light on everyone. And the Lamb will conquer, and the woman clothed in the sun will shine her light on everyone. Golden rose, as we kneel with our love before you, Lady of Knock, my Queen of Peace. Lady of Knock, our Queen of Peace.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother James may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother James. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it help ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again, when the love of Christ must conquer all things, destroys even death itself.
present him to God. Present this soul to God Most High. Give eternal rest, O Lord, and may your light shine on him forever.
Father of mercies, we commend our brother James in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon James in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us to remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and James forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. James, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the honored martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem.
Dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life. Say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings. Shine like the sun and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no under his wings your refuge, his faithfulness your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun,